Hello, welcome to the Computer Literacy Center's online instructional video about inserting images, shapes, and icons in Microsoft Word. These elements can help you create appealing and engaging documents for professional and personal use. My name is Eileen Cummings and I will guide you through this tutorial. In this video, you will create an engaging document in Microsoft Word by inserting some of the available elements. You will insert images, shapes, and icons. You will also edit these elements after inserting them. If you'd like to follow along with the instructions, download the image attached to this video. To get started, open Microsoft Word. Word automatically opens to the template page where you can select the type of document you would like to create. Select Blank Document. This creates a blank document for you to edit. Images are useful elements to use in documents as they communicate information and emotion without using any words. They help to engage viewers visually and emotionally so they connect more with the message of your document. There are two ways to insert images into a Word document, from the internet and from your device. To insert an image from the internet, navigate to the Insert tab in the ribbon, then select Online Pictures in the Illustrations group. This opens a window where you can search for images or use preset search categories to find images. Click on the car search category and select a picture of a car you like, then click the Insert button. This inserts the image you selected into the document. In older versions of Word, there aren't any preset search categories, so type car in the Search Bing search bar and press Enter, then select a picture of a car you like, and then click the Insert button. This inserts the image you selected into the document. Click in the gray space to the side of your document to deselect the image. Now you're ready to insert an image from your computer. To insert an image from your computer, navigate back to the Insert tab and click on Pictures in the Illustrations group. This opens File Explorer. Click on Downloads in the left sidebar. This shows you all of the files you've recently downloaded. The classic car image you downloaded at the beginning of this video should be at the top of the list. Select it, then press Insert. This inserts the image in the document. The images take up a lot of space in the document, so you'll need to shrink them to make sure the other elements will fit. To shrink them, select the first image, then click and drag one of the corner handles toward the center of the picture to shrink it down. That's better. Do the same to the second image. Perfect. Now you can add shapes to the document. To do that, navigate to the Insert tab and select the Shapes dropdown in the Illustrations group. This opens a drop-down menu with different types of shapes such as basic shapes, block arrows, and equation shapes. Select the first rectangle in the Rectangles section. This closes the menu and changes your cursor into a crosshair, indicating that you're ready to insert the shape. To place the rectangle, move your cursor to an empty part of your document, then click and drag across your document. As you drag, Word shows an outline of the shape to indicate what size it will be when you let go. Once it's a size you like, release your left mouse button and the rectangle is placed in the document. The Format tab automatically opens so you can customize your shape. To change the color of your shape, click on the Shape Fill drop-down menu in the Shape Styles group. This opens a drop-down menu of colors for you to choose from for your shape's main color. Select a color you like, I'm choosing dark blue. The rectangle's color automatically changes to match your choice. To change the shape's outline, select the Shape Outline drop-down in the Shape Styles group. This opens another drop-down menu of colors for you to choose from for the outline of your shape. Select a color you like, I'm choosing dark red. This changes the outline of your shape to match the color you chose. It's hard to see the outline, so open the Shape Outline menu again and select Weight. This opens a small menu of different weight or thickness options you can choose from. Select a weight you like, I'm choosing 3-point. This makes the outline of your shape thicker, so it's easier to see the color you selected. To make the rectangle appear more dynamic, you can add shape effects. To do that, select the Shape Effects drop-down menu in the Shape Styles group. This opens a drop-down menu filled with different effects you can apply to your shape. Click on the Glow option and a side menu of different glow effects opens to the right of the main menu. To see how the effect will look, hover your cursor over different options, then click on one that you like. I'm choosing a blue glow effect. That looks great! To make the shape even more dynamic, you can adjust the edges to make it unique. To do that, click on the Edit Shape drop-down menu in the Insert Shapes group and select Edit Points. This places black squares on each corner of your shape, and when you hover your cursor over these black squares, your cursor changes to a square with four arrows. This indicates that you can click and drag your cursor to move the point, which adjusts the corners of your shape. Move the corners of your shape a bit. When you move the black squares around, two white squares appear on the sides of the shape adjacent to the black square, which allow you to change the curvature of the sides of your shape. Move the white squares to curve the sides of your shape. Awesome! Another way to insert a shape that is not listed within the Shapes drop-down menu is to create one from scratch. Click on the Insert Shapes drop-down menu in the Insert Shapes group. This opens a menu of all the different shapes you can insert into your document. Select the Free Form Shape option in the Lines section. This changes your cursor to a crosshair. Click and drag to draw freeform lines on your document, or click and move the cursor a short distance and click again to add anchor points to create straight lines. To finish drawing the shape, connect the lines together. This fills the space in between the lines, and you can change the size and color of your custom shape. Change the fill color, and outline weight to match your other shape. Great! Now you're ready to insert an icon into your document. Navigate to the Insert tab and select the Icons button in the Illustrations group. The Icons window might take a few seconds to load. As you can see, there are various categories of icons you can select in the left sidebar. Above the categories is a search bar you can use to search for specific icons, and in the main portion of the window is a comprehensive gallery of icons available to you. Type car in the search bar and select one of the options, then click Insert. This inserts the icon into your document. Similar to when you inserted the shapes into your document, the ribbon switches to the Format tab so you can edit the design of your icon. Apply the same tools you used on your shapes to change the fill color and outline color of your icon to colors you like. Then click on the Graphics Effects drop-down menu and click on the Reflection effect. Select one of the variations you like. I'm choosing the Full Reflection Touching effect. The elements are all really close together. To spread them out, select an element, I'll start with the top car picture, and click on the Layout Options icon to the right of the element. This opens a menu of different layout options you can choose from to change how your elements interact with each other. Select the In Front of Text option. This moves the element you selected in front of all the other elements. Move it out of the way for a second and apply the same layout to all of your other elements so you can move them all freely, then arrange them in a way you like. Perfect! In this video, you created an engaging document using different elements available in Microsoft Word. You inserted images from the web and from your computer. You also inserted and edited shapes, and inserted and edited an icon. For more information about Microsoft Word and other computer literacy topics, please visit our website at weber.edu/clc.